This Paladin Piper Codger Hour sponsored in part by Medico Gold Crest Pipes. 24 karat gold in every pipe.
Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Give him two lips like roses and clover. Then tell him that his lonesome nights are over. Sandman, I'm so alone. Don't have nobody to call my own. Please turn on your magic beam. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Give him the word that I'm not a tell him that his lonesome nights are over, Sandman. I'm so alone. Don't have nobody to call my own. Please turn on your magic beam. Oh, Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Bum 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 bum. Mr. Sandman.
Yes.
Bring us a dream. Give him a pair of eyes with a come hither gleam. Give him a lonely heart like Pagliacci. And lots of wavy hair like Liberace. Mr. Sandman, someone to hold.
Someone to hold.
Would be so peachy before we're too old. So please turn on your magic beam. Sandman, bring us, please, 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 Mr. Sandman, bring us a dream.
Get out those old records, those old phonograph records, the ones we used to play so long ago. What if they sound scratchy? The tunes really were catchy, and especially those that said I love you so. I used to beg you over and over just to set the wedding day. To get you courtable, I'd bring my portable and melt your heart away. With all those old records, those old phonograph records, the ones we used to play so long ago. Those old
all the ones about
records, those old
all the ones about
records, the ones we used to play so long ago.
On the old wind-up Victrola, Barney Google was great.
The tunes,
all the songs
really
about Kate,
and especially
jada,
those
jada,
that
boo,
said I love you so.
Yucca, hula, hickey,
I used
hula,
to beg
honey,
you over and over,
Dardanella
just
and
to
sonny,
set the wedding day.
Meet me on
to
the back
get you portable,
songs,
I'd bring my portable
songs,
and melt your heart away. With all those old
they were wonderful
records, those old
play them over again.
Records, the ones we used to play so long ago. The ones we used to play so long ago.
I'm no millionaire,
but I'm not the type to care. 'Cause I've got a pocket full of dreams. It's my universe, even with an empty purse. 'Cause I've got a pocket full of dreams. I wouldn't take the wealth on Wall Street for a road where nature trots. And I calculate that I am worth my weight in golden rods. Lucky, lucky me, I can live in luxury, 'cause I've got a pocket full of dreams. Type to care, 'cause I've got a pocket full of dreams. It's my universe, even with an empty purse, 'cause I've got a pocket full of dreams. I would take all the wealth of Wall Street for a road when nature tries, and I calculate that I am worth my way in golden rods. Lucky, lucky me, I can live in luxury, 'cause I've got a pocket full of
dreams. Empty. I'm afraid I'm a real tobacco addict. Evidence of a mind enfeebled and a will enslaved, as Oliver Wendell Holmes used to say. Do you know this? I can't do without the things. Not even here in this gorgeous countryside round about the Gorton Gap. Well, I got them here in Gorton. But when I was in the shop, I made another purchase. This, a clay pipe. It cost me tuppence, and it's part, incidentally, of a consignment of about 12 groats that arrived here some 20 years ago. There are only 30 left, so it's a real vintage clay pipe. Now, as I looked at them, I began to wonder, are there many of them still smoked up here in this part of the world? How long do they last? What sort of a smoke are they? Of course, you know, the handmade clay pipe is not the only thing that belongs to the past. Another is the woman pipe smoker, a swiftly vanishing race. Now, I heard about Mary Ward, who lives up here at Ballinasallis, about 3 miles from Plum Bridge and 8 from Strabane, and who still, I'm told, enjoys the solace of a draw at her clay pipe. Miss Mary Ward?
Yes.
Could I come in for
yes,
a minute?
Yes, you can, surely.
Thank you very
come
much.
Come right in.
Thank you.
Well, Mary, it seems to be a very lonely sort of life you lead up here.
It is a very lonely life.
What sort of company have you at all?
I've nothing but three cats and a dog.
Well, that's not much good, is it, really, for anybody?
No, it is not.
Do you do any reading at all?
No, I can't read.
Well, now, Mary, if you're not able to read and with no company here but the dogs and the cats and living away out here on your own, what would you say is your main comfort in life?
Well, all the comfort I have is a smoke out of the old clay pipe. I find it brighter. And smoking the wooden pipe.
When did you begin at it?
I always smoked the old clay pipe from my mother learned me when I was 7 years old.
Oh, how did that happen?
Rising in the night time to light out of the pipe 2 or 3 times in the night.
She smoked the pipe and you had to fill it for her?
Yes, I had.
And you've been at it ever since?
I've been at it ever since.
How much would you smoke in a week, say?
Well, I would smoke 3 ounces in a week.
Mm-hmm.
If I would have it, and sometimes I wouldn't have it, for I wouldn't be fit to afford to buy it.
Supposing you run out of tobacco now, what happens?
I take a draw of tea.
Thank you very much, Mary, for the crack that you've given me here this afternoon. And because I know what it's like to be without a cigarette, I have brought you along here 3 pipes, there you are, and a bit of tobacco for yourself. I think it's the sort
you
smoke.
Thank you for the plug.
Thank you, Mary.
Thank you very much.
Not at all. Now I'll be on my way.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
And this is Pamela with our first item on display, an elegant slender-line 9-inch pipe with rounded gold briar-lined bowl, chased gold stem, and vulcanite mouthpiece, just perfect for evening wear. For the sporting look, Jennifer shows us a curved stem briar with chunky beveled-edged hexagonal bowl. And finally, Jackie, in romantic mood, wielding a 9-inch clay church warden with red mouthpiece so that the lips don't stick, nor the lipstick either.
Well, I'd like to see them smoke pipes, but I think they've got to smoke them in the right place. For instance, they can't smoke, if a secretary, she couldn't smoke it in the office, could she?
Well, personally, I don't think pipes and miniskirts go very well, you know. I don't, the smell might put a fella off, you know.
And another thing, if a woman smokes a pipe for any period of time, she's going to have a deformed lip, isn't she? She's going to look ugly and terrible. And what about a woman cocking her heel up and knocking it out? Hey, I mean, in a miniskirt, you'd get pinched, wouldn't you?
Well, I think in these days, with the equality of sexes, there's no reason why women shouldn't smoke a pipe. I mean, there's no reason why pipe smoking should be a male institution any more than drinking pints.
Rather convenient. Means I only have to carry one pack of tobacco for both of us instead of tobacco for me and cigarettes for her.
I can't really see a woman handling a pipe the way you do, though.
Well, I don't see why not. They handle everything else from hockey sticks to swords. They can handle a pipe, I think, especially if it's a ladylike pipe that they've got. Blend in quite nicely.
First of all, you've got to have a pipe, usually. Well, this is a fabulous lady's pipe, so that's about the best one you can start with. This is a nice mild tobacco too. Just have a smell, see if you like it. It's chocolate flavoured, this one. Okay. Put your palm out and I'll show you an easy way of filling a pipe. That's a bit too much, it's only a small bowl.
Right.
Loosen the tobacco up so that you don't have anything like that. Now, gently swirl the pipe onto your hand so that if you hold it further down, you get a stronger grip. That it fills itself. Lovely, very good. I'm sure you've had a sneaky try at it sometime or other.
I've been watching you. Now.
That's it. Put the rest.
Lots of different kinds of tobaccos.
Oh, yes, it's a beautiful selection, actually. Some gorgeous ladies' ones. You have chocolate flavoured, rum flavoured, coffee. Oh, it's a very good selection. Right, now, this is a difficult bit, so some people say, but it's really very easy. Right? It's a suck and blow, and don't inhale. Not yet, anyway. Oh, very good. Fabulous. You know what they say about people who smoke pipes awfully well? They're very good kissers. So you must have had practice somewhere along the line.
I beg your pardon.
You look like an experienced pipe smoker. How long have you been smoking it?
I've been smoking a pipe for about 5 years, but I've been smoking cigarettes for a good many years.
What made you take it up?
Because I was told it was better for me, uh-huh. and it was more satisfying to smoke, which is definitely true.
Well, what's your husband say about it?
He doesn't mind.
He's smoking himself?
He smokes a pipe himself, and so does my son.
Now, have you given up cigarette smoking and taken more to pipes since the doctor's report came out?
No. Just carried on just the same.
Well, now, you're a pipe maker. Is it true that more women are smoking them?
There has been a tendency to increase in the demand in the last few weeks, particularly since the medical report.
Mm-hmm. Do you think the trend is here to stay?
I'm not so sure. I hope so, naturally. And I think from the ladies' point of view, they'll get much more satisfaction if they do continue and persevere with ladies' pipes. After all said and done, ladies' pipes have been smoked for a long time in Scandinavia. And you can go back to many years when people in the west coast of Ireland, they even smoked, the ladies there even smoked clay pipes. So the trend in this country is somewhat new, but has been established in many other countries for some years.
From 1844's Hints on Etiquette and the Usages of Tobacco in Society. If you are so unfortunate as to have contracted the low habit of smoking, be careful to practice it under certain restrictions, at least so long as you are desirous of being considered fit for civilized society. The first mark of a gentleman is a sensitive regard for the feelings of others. Therefore, smoke where it is least likely to prove personally offensive by making your clothes smell. Then, wash your mouth and brush your teeth. What man of delicacy could presume to address a lady with his breath smelling of onions? Yet tobacco is equally odious. The tobacco smoker in public is the most selfish animal imaginable. He perseveres in contaminating the pure and fragrant air, careless whom he annoys, and is but the fitting inmate of a tavern. Smoking in the streets or in the theater is only practiced by shop boys, pseudo-fashionables, and the swell mob. All songs that you may see written in praise of smoking in magazines or newspapers or hear sung upon the stage are puffs, paid for by the proprietors of cigar divans and tobacco shops to make their trade popular, and therefore believe nor be deluded by them. The pipe is a powerful rival to wife or maid, and no wonder that at last the woman succumbs, consents, and rather than lose her lord or master, even supplies the hated herb with her own fair hands. And this is what women have come to do on the continent. But in America, they have gone further and admitted the rival to their very drawing rooms, where the unmanly husband stretches his legs on the sofa, smokes, and spits on the carpet. Far be it from our English women to permit such habits, and yet, as things are, a little concession is prudent. One must never smoke, nor even ask to smoke, in the company of the fair. If they know that in a few minutes you will be running off to your cigar, the fair will do well, say it is in a garden or so, to allow you to bring it out and smoke it there. One must never smoke again in the streets, that is, in daylight. One must never smoke in a public place where ladies arrow or might be, for instance, a flower show or promenade. One may smoke in a railway carriage in spite of its bylaws, if one has first obtained the consent of everyone present. But if there be a lady there, though she give her consent, smoke not. In 9 cases out of 10, she will give it from good nature. One must never smoke in a closed carriage. One may ask to obtain leave to smoke when retaining from a picnic or expedition in an open carriage. One must never smoke in a theater or race course, nor in church. The last is not, perhaps, a needless caution. In the Belgian churches, you see a placard announcing, "Ici on ne mange pas du tabac." One must never smoke when anybody shows an objective to it. One must never smoke a pipe in the streets. One must never smoke at all in the coffee room of a hotel. One must never smoke without consent in the presence of a clergyman. And one must never offer a cigar to any ecclesiastic over the rank of CM8.
If you smoke, or if you are in the company of smokers and are to wear your clothes in the presence of ladies afterwards, you must change them to smoke in. A host who asks you to smoke will generally offer you an old coat for that purpose. You must also, after smoking, rinse your mouth out well, and if possible, brush your teeth. You should never smoke in another person's house without leave, and you should not ask leave to do so if there are ladies in the house. When you are going to smoke a cigar yourself, you should offer one at the same time to anybody present, if not a clergyman or a very old man. You should always smoke a cigar given to you, whether good or bad, and never make any remarks on its quality. From 1897's Manners for Men. The etiquette in this, as many other matters, has quite altered during the past few years. At one time, it was considered a sign of infamously bad taste to smoke in the presence of women under any circumstances. But it is now no longer so. So many women smoke themselves that in some houses even the drawing room is thrown open to Princess Nicotine. The example of the Prince of Wales has been largely instrumental in sweeping away the old restrictions. He smokes almost incessantly. It is now no uncommon thing to see a man in evening dress smoking a Brigham with a lady on their way to opera, theater, or dinner engagement. From 1898's Etiquette for Americans. The modification of old-fashioned rules in this regard has made the lines faint. It is true, and there is no book on etiquette that does not reprehend as unbecoming a gentleman smoking in drawing rooms, boudoirs, dining rooms, restaurants, where now men not only are allowed and invited to smoke, but where highly respectable women have been known to join them. Gentlemen in this country do smoke, when at home, in the drawing room, and dining room. There is no doubt about that. That is, when the women of the family do not object. Most women have a decided objection to bedroom smoking. It is not a wise practice, on any account, to use up the freshness of bedroom air. But putting aside old-fashioned prejudices and out-of-date notions, as many feasible dislikes of women are called, a man should never smoke anywhere without first assuring himself that it is not disagreeable to the ladies in the room and in the house. A gentleman paying an afternoon visit should not smoke unless others begin, and even then it should be some one in authority, and not a younger brother, for instance, or a cheeky caller who leads him on. He should never smoke before the ladies have left the dining room, except in unusual circumstances. He should not smoke when anyone with a real voice is singing, for tobacco smoke is death to vocal success and causes great discomfort to singers whose throats, being highly trained, are proverbially sensitive. Smoking in the streets is allowed and cannot be checked unless rules do not reach the masses, unless enforced by police regulations. An American gentleman does not smoke when he is walking with a lady, or where he is likely to meet a lady. No one but a sensitive woman knows how unpleasant it is in a crowded thoroughfare to walk exactly behind a man whose cigar is not of high order, and men are sometimes cognizant of this fact, but rarely. The etiquette of smoking among women has not reached the stage where it permits the habit to be publicly indulged. Women are obliged to smoke in corners when they are at clubs or races. How long this state of things will continue, it is impossible to say. At the present rate of progress, women and young girls will be smoking in the streets with men. It is a horror and a crying shame, for the debasing character of the custom will inevitably destroy the delicacy of women. From Emily Post's Etiquette in Society, 1922. A gentleman should not smoke under the following circumstances: when walking on the street with a lady, when lifting his hat or bowing, in a room, an office, or elevator, when a lady enters, in any short conversation where he is standing near or talking with a lady. If he has seated himself for a conversation with a lady on a veranda, in a hotel, in a private house, anywhere where smoking is permitted, he must first ask, "Do you mind if I smoke?" And if she replies, "Not at all," or "Do, by all means," it is then proper for him to do so. He should, however, take out his cigar, pipe, or cigarette out of his mouth while he is speaking. One who is very adroit can say a word or two without an unpleasant grimace, but one should not talk with one's mouth full of food or barricaded with tobacco. In the country, a gentleman may walk with a lady and smoke at the same time, especially a pipe or cigarette. Why a cigar is less admissible is hard to determine, unless a pipe somehow belongs to the country. A gentleman in golf or country clothes with a pipe in his mouth and a dog at his heels suggests a picture fitting to the scene, while a cigar seems as out of place as a cutaway coat. A pipe on the street in a city, on the other hand, is less appropriate than a cigar in the country. In any event, he will, of course, ask his companion's permission to smoke.
Well, guys, hope you enjoyed this month's Codger Hour. And, as you could see, even back in the early 1900s, late 1800s, people still didn't like smoking. So, before we get started, I don't know how this happened, but my yellow bowl. Guys, you can see that. There you go. My yellow bowl check tool. Look how clean it is. That's because I dishwashed it. Accidentally. But they go through the dishwasher pretty well.
Move this up a little bit. Oh, it might make things worse. I don't know.
All right. So before we go any further, from our sponsor, S.M. Frank, and the Medico Goldcrest line, I am smoking a Medico Goldcrest Shape 103 Billiard. And this was a gift from the Southland Piper maybe a year or two ago. Wonderful little pipe. And in it, we have actually Boswell's Honey Roast tonight. I have actually run out of velvet, and I need to open a new Codger Corner. So, Boswell's Honey Roast it was tonight. So, pipe smoking etiquette and the etiquette around ladies. Definitely, society has had some interesting rules on smoking even back then. When you did it, when you didn't. Who would like it? Who wouldn't? Even if people tell you they like it, they'll like it. I gotta get this thing lit. So, I thought I would reread. Now, I've done this once before on the channel, but I wanted to do a Codger Hour devoted to pipe smoking etiquette. So I thought I'd reread the most important pipe smoking document that has been written. And that is the pipe smoking laws. Mm-hmm. So, law number one. If the purpose of your gathering is, in part or in whole, the use and consumption of tobacco, any product, tobacco product, or accessory on the table may be used by anyone in attendance. A smoker who uses another's tobacco need not ask permission, but must offer commentary on that blend. Pipes are excluded from general use, but may be fondled and oogled at any time. Again, with commentary. Anyone given a standing offer to help himself or herself to a friend's tobacco need never ask for permission. However, it is still necessary to acknowledge the taking of said tobacco. A simple, "I stole a cigar," shall suffice. Matches and lighters should be shared without hesitation, but a smoker should only hold the lighter while lighting for a member of the opposite sex. We touched on that a little earlier in the Codger Hour, didn't we? Pipe smoking law number 4. Corncob pipes are still pipes, unless they're from China. Number 5. It is not acceptable to show off a new pipe to brag about how much you spent or how impressive a pipe you could afford. The exception occurs if said pipe purchase caused your divorce. Then anything goes. You may also tell others the price you told your wife or significant other that you paid for it. I believe that rule applies to guns as well. Law number 6. It is only acceptable to encourage pipe acquisition disorder, abbreviated PAD, and tobacco acquisition disorder, abbreviated DAD. Such compulsive purchases may never be discouraged. We don't do that here in the YTPC. We are very supportive of each other. Pipes and cigars may be used as pointers to enhance a discussion or monologue, or in physical expression in general pontification. They may never be used, however, as swords. Number 8. Smokers should make a good faith effort to use tobacco away from non-smokers. But if someone pretends to cough, the smoker is allowed to pretend to ignore the cougher. This is doubly true if the tobacco is unlit, in which case the smoker may blow pretend smoke in the cougher's face. Any pipe or cigar smoker living within 50 miles of a locally owned tobacconist specializing in his or her tobacco of choice must patronize the business for at least 4 times a year. Within 10 miles, it shall be monthly at a minimum. Any smoker insisting others use any high-end product, be it pipe, cigar, or tobacco, or accessory, should supply it. Anyone not willing to buy his friends a Dunhill needs to keep quiet about them. When it comes to tobacco-fueled social gatherings, it is not a lie. If it is not a lie, it is not worth telling. Number 12. You can make fun of someone who is sending you free tobacco, but you shouldn't if you want that to continue. Talking. My pipe goes out. I'll finish these and then we'll chat a little longer. Among the group, the person who smokes a pipe, wears glasses, has a beard, is, by default, the smartest and most reliable person in the room. If more than one person fits this description, seniority will be determined by the highest percentage of naturally bald scalp. Number 14. You can smoke a pipe, yet not be a pipe smoker. You must elicit the accompanying and misleading sense of wisdom to be accepted as such. And the last final pipe smoking law. Smoking a cigar around pipe smokers and vice versa is encouraged, but anyone who lights a cigarette when higher quality tobaccos are readily available invites the mocking of his or her peers. So yes, this hangs down in Codger Corner on the other side that you guys didn't see in the intro. If you couldn't tell, some of that was tongue-in-cheek. But needless to say, it's a fun hobby. And while social norms have really, if you really read into the program that I presented to you, which I did, social norms really haven't changed that much. It almost made it sound like, when my research, that it was just more tolerated than anything. Now, I am in my 40s. So I can remember smoking in restaurants, smoking in bars, smoking at the track. Smoking in casinos. Most places, you know, but they had sections that were designated non-smoker smoker. And, excuse me, my burp. My fondest smell memories were always of pipe tobacco. Now, when I grew older, and, you know, pipes just kind of died away, as we all mostly know, for a long time. They're sort of making a comeback now, which is wonderful. And I got into cigars in college. I really enjoyed the smell of the cedar in the humidors, so the big humidors, the walk-in humidors that you would go into. And the only place that I knew initially, when I was in college, was a liquor barn. It wasn't until later that we had I want to say J. Alexander's, but that's not correct. It's downtown. And I didn't even know about Kramer's until a few years ago. But my favorite cigars were Marcus Daniels cigars out of Florida. I went in there, I happened to be down there on work, and they were hand rolling one night, and I thought that was the coolest thing ever. These guys were rolling you up a cigar. They'd roll you up a whatever, a Corona, a Torpedo, a Churchill, whatever. And I did get a box of those, and I savored them. They were very, very good. And if I had to go back down there, I'd always just pop in and grab a, you know, they do 3 or 5 packs back then. They just wrap them in the little thing. They weren't all hand rolled, I mean, but you know, but it was nice. But I remember being in that shop, and there was a lady that I sat with who smoked pipe, and she said she really enjoyed pipe smoking for the aromatics and things like that. And she said that area in Florida was one of the few areas that you could actually walk down the street and smoke a pipe and nobody would care, you know. Speaking of walking down the street smoking a pipe, outdoors, my wife and I visited Mackinac Island years ago. And you want to talk about somewhere that makes old Paladin's heart sing? Mackinac Island. If you guys have not been there, it's like stepping back in time to the 1800s. There is no vehicles. There's only horse-drawn carriages, bikes, and walking. And to get there, you got to take a shuttle ferry. Put that together, it's a sherry. And we walked down their main street, and that was when I'd first gotten into pipe tobacco. So it was probably 2010, 2011. And I'll never forget it. I had a Brigham, Klondike, I believe. It was a straight billiard. And I smoked Orlick Golden Slice. And I remember there was tons of cigar shops there. And one was really fancy. And I didn't go in because I had a tin of Orlick. So I was like, why do I need to go in there? I wish I would have gone in there. But anyway, I remember walking down the street and smelling this beautiful cedar smell. And my wife looked at me and said, boy, I'm glad you got into pipes and got out of cigars. And I said, why is that, honey? She goes, because cigars stink and those don't, pipes don't. Now we know how she feels about Latakia. But generally speaking, she enjoys the pipe a whole lot more than the smell of cigars. But so I also thought about, because of the etiquette part and the little bit that we talked about with toward the late 1800s and 1920s, that realm, that women were starting to smoke more. And so that's why I went ahead and put all those clips of lady pipe smokers in there. The Irish one I thought was very interesting, where she lives alone and doesn't talk to anybody. I felt like that was bad acting. But at the same time, maybe it was true. I don't know. And I still, to this day, have not bought a clay pipe. I need to get one eventually. But yeah. So, guys, I hope you enjoyed this Codger Hour. I really enjoy making these. And I hope you got something out of it. And if you get a chance, just a disclaimer, since if you stayed this long, I am not sponsored by SM Frank. Would love to be. He'll sponsor me. I would just be like, you know, send me a pipe occasionally. But I love the history of that brand. I was so lucky to get to talk to Mr. Feuerbach. And we looked at some patent stuff. He sent me that stuff over the internet. Great, great guy. But anyway, if you get a chance, you got to try Medico Pipe. I believe you're probably your best bet these days is going to be eBay. But their Goldcrest line was their flagship, top of the line, luxury tiered product, right? And yeah, it was a gimmick like everything else. But the gold did reinforce the shank, so you could. You can take this apart hot, then it won't crack. And so it's a nice smoker from yesteryear. Most of the Gold Crest, the older Gold Crest look more like this. The newer Gold Crest lines that Mr. Feuerbach was making had more of a Danish stem on it. They did have a Silver Crest line for a little bit. That I was able to, when I got in touch with Bill, he actually made me one. And I showcased that on here a while back. And I still to this day have not smoked it because that's special to me. You don't get that very often. So anyway, but yeah, pick you up a Medico pipe. I think you'll enjoy them, whether you're a filtered smoker or not. So, all right, guys. Once again, I hope you enjoyed this. And we will see you very soon, once again, on another Codger Hour and Paladin Piper video. Take care, guys.